Would you like to see something? It'll blow your mind. It looks like real magic. Come over here.
What?
Let's try something bigger.
Oh my God.
Isn't that great? High five.
Today, we're gonna learn about LED lights, the changing and mixing of colors, and if you stick around to the end, you might just see an illusion of luminous proportions. Welcome to a Big Apple-sized edition of Impossible Science.
In 1976, in order to celebrate the nation's bicentennial, the Empire State Building lit up red, white, and blue. And ever since then, they've used the Empire State Building to celebrate holidays, events, and groups that make up the diverse community of New York City. In 2012, they updated to a state-of-the-art LED system on the top of the Empire State Building that is capable of lighting over 16 million different colors. Sounds pretty impossible to me. Old-fashioned light bulbs, or what we call incandescent lights, work by sending electricity through a thin wire or a filament that glows super hot and energy gives off light. But an LED works by sending electricity through a light-emitting diode. It doesn't give off as much heat, it's much more energy efficient, and comes in red, green, and blue, which is where the color mixing comes in.
You may have heard that primary colors are red, yellow, and blue. However, this is only true when you're dealing with paint or anything with a colored surface that we see light being reflected off of. Light itself actually has three different primary colors: red, green, and blue. When mixing together paints or even anything with a physical object with color, such as a drink, ink, or even your favorite ice cream, they use a subtractive system, which means the more colors you add together, the less color you'll see, so the darker your mix becomes. We've all seen this. Mix together all your colors of paint, and what do you get? That's right, black, the darkest color of all. Now, light itself behaves differently. It uses an additive system. With light, the more colors you add together, the more color you'll see, and the brighter the mix becomes, which is why equal amounts of red, green, and blue equals white.
To help us better understand lighting and color matching, let's bring on someone who is responsible for some of the most iconic lighting and visual images on the planet. Marc Brickman is the visual artist for the lighting of the Empire State Building, and he's come on the show. Marc, thank you so much for joining us on Impossible Science.
How are you, Jason? Good to see you. Thank you for having me.
You know, most of the time you don't really think about it. When you're a kid, you learn about primary colors, red, blue, and yellow, right? And then you get into lighting and it's red, blue, and green.
So in each bulb, in each LED, you have the red, green, blue, and in some of them you have the white, in other ones it's just solid, and then we have additional white. Each enclosure has 255 possibilities of color. So the white light that's on the building to this day, you know, it would had to match the old color temperature of the metal halide lamps that had been there for years. They call it Empire State Building white. So the white light is really important in the whole. There's actually extra white light installed to give you this really beautiful look on the building. Really an unusual installation.
But it's different, but it's also iconic. Everyone is so proud of that building and the work you've done.
I'm so lucky. I'm the luckiest man in the world. I really am.
Well, it's absolutely beautiful. Thank you so much for just coming on the show and talking about your experiences with the Empire State Building.
Thank you.
Now that we understand LEDs and color changing, what if I told you they gave me permission to change the color of the building? Yeah, so I went on Fifth Avenue to see if I could find someone to help me out.
Would you like to see a cool science experiment? You've got to check this out. Do you like science?
Sure.
Here, come here, check this out. Science experiment, it looks like magic, but I promise you, it's just science. Vedant, pleasure to meet you, Vedant. I'm Jason. Check this out. Do you see any color in there? Hold it up to light, no color in it. There's no color in that filter, right?
But watch what happens when I put in front of a flashlight and a second polarizing filter.
You can actually see that there's color in it, see?
Oh yeah.
Now if I actually rotate, you can see a change.
Oh, wow.
It's pretty amazing already. Mm-hmm. But I have a cooler one. This piece of plastic, you hold on to that, and miss, if you would.
Yeah.
I have a Rubik's Cube here with six different colors on it, okay?
Okay.
I'm gonna let you pick any color you'd like. You get to rattle around in your hands, and then I want you to pick the top color. That's your color, but I don't want anybody to know what it is except for you.
Okay.
All right, now the one thing I don't want you to do is pick white. Okay, I want you to think of that color and only that color.
Okay.
I'm gonna try to get this piece of clear plastic to change to your color, all right? See if I can project that color. Do you see it? No? Let's try something. Oh. Here, I'll try to do it against the wall there. Do you see it there? No? Do you see it up against the wall?
No.
let's try something bigger. Here, I'll go like this. Here, if I take it like this, see that? See any color? Here, I'll rotate it just like I rotated the other filter.
Is that yours?
Is it red?
It's red. Is it red? Look at that.
Like this. See if I can get the color to project right there. Oh, is it orange? Is it orange?
Yes. Do I show it?
Yeah, is it orange? This is the strongest flashlight I've ever seen. You guys are fantastic. You have a great night. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
I want to give a huge thank you to everyone that participated on this episode for the Empire State Building. And if you want to learn more about LEDs or actually how to do LED art with the Empire State Building on your own, well, then make sure you click the link below. And if you couldn't believe that I just did a magic trick with the LEDs on the building, make sure you like the video and share the video with your friends. And until next time, stay curious. Because the right question changes everything.
Check on the building.
Is that yours?
I'm happy that works. I had to replace the building if it didn't.